to a locker, that way the parents can sit in there. So feel free to ask parents, they'll move.
Yeah, I heard it.
You have about 1 minute. Is there someone there? Jay, you wanna help pull out some chairs?
Yep.
We'll close with this. And I stepped in something sticky. That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. Get started. First thing, thank you. Obviously, the turnout is awesome. So this is a great start. I'm extremely excited. So there is a lot of slides, but just there's a lot of those reminders for us. So don't freak out. We'll try to get you through here as fast as we can. Obviously, ask questions. So stop us and ask a question if you're confused or if you don't want to. I'll be here after and I'll hang out for a bit so we can talk. So definitely ask questions if something's confusing. So this is our coaching staff. I'm not going to read it all. There's a lot of guys in here, a lot of volunteers that have been with us for a long time, and then we'll have some new volunteers. One I want to point out is Coach Zorich, Greg Zorich. I'm not sure where Greg's over there. So Greg's been with us for years, and he left. He coached me, actually, and then came back years later, so we're happy to have Greg. What is that? Surprise. No, that sound. Sounds like something's. So the guy's going in there. So Coach Davenport, he has a black hat on. That's Chris Davenport. He's our strength and conditioning guy. So those people that have been coming to workouts, he's the guy that's getting your kids stronger and faster. He's also our offensive coordinator. Chris has been with us for, probably going on 7 or 8 years now. Coach Reese, Trevor Reese, he's a teacher at Whiting, and he's our defensive coordinator, and Reese has been with us since 2016. Coach Gendris has been with us since like 2014. He's moving to be our junior varsity head coach, so a lot of us are young, obviously first-year players here. Coach Gendris will be your coach, and he'll talk a little bit towards the end. I'm Coach Jennings, Brett Jennings. This is my first year as a head coach. I've been defensive coordinator, offensive line coach for a long time here. So that's our staff and a bunch of other guys you'll find out along the way. One guy that you guys probably recognize is Coach Ford. He's our special teams coach. He wasn't able to be here today. So that's Coach Ford, though. He's been with us since 2015. He graduated from Whiting and he coached for a long time at Griffith. So we have a ton of experience on here. So it's a good staff and they work their behinds off. So we're going to talk a little bit very quickly about philosophy. I know, you can kind of take it as you want, but we really do kind of focus on our philosophy. And the first thing, and you probably have seen it on social media or all that stuff. Obviously, we have a big old poster that we just got put up that we're pretty proud of. That's do work, and that's our mantra and what we always talk about. And do work, and you can see it there. John Bach defined it for us, and that's to get things done. Accomplish goals, push their limits, achieve satisfaction, and most of all, give everything they got. And that's all based around the guy in the middle of the O there that gets me choked up every time I talk about him. That's Coach Vic. He passed away in 2014. He was 28 years old. Pretty young guy. So we're always working to, I don't mean to make this awkward, I apologize. But we're always working to make Coach Vic proud, and we talk about do work and all that stuff. So we're always going to keep his legacy alive as long as we're all here. So we have a scholarship named after Coach Vic. We give away to a senior at the end of the year. This past year, we gave away $5,000 to three seniors, a total of about $8,000 over the last few years. So we're pretty proud of it, and that's what that purpose of that sign is. So do work. That's what we're all about. Kind of what we try to do here at Whiting is we're trying to make or help create good husbands and fathers. And most of us here are husbands and fathers. We fail. A lot as husbands and fathers, but we're constantly working to get better. I mean, yesterday, I smashed my four-month-old head of my son into the crib, and my wife was extremely upset with me. But we're always trying to be better, right? And that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to lead by example and show our players that there's a lot more to life than football. This is just a sounding board for us to kind of get out some important lessons that sports and football have taught us. And we kind of base around three things. We call them kind of the foundational values, at least I do. And they're based on those three things: respect, commitment, and discipline. I feel like as a coach, we have had great teams through the years, they're kind of based on these three things. You know, those are tough words, and a whole lot of people don't like to get involved with those words, but respect, it's how you treat someone says a lot about you, and that's what it says up there. But, as you know, a good person is going to be respectful to a teacher, as they would be respectful to the janitor, same deal. Doesn't matter, respect is respect, and we work hard to instill that in our kids. They walk in the weight room. Every single kid that walks in that weight room says hi, coach, every single day, and says goodbye, coach, every single day. And when you don't, you sure as heck gonna get called out on it. And that's what being a good kid is about. Commitment, you made a promise to the program, we're gonna hold you accountable to the promise. That's the big thing. We're gonna hold you accountable. And accountable is a tough word nowadays. It's a tough word because when you hold someone accountable, sometimes you get yourself in trouble. But that's what we're here for. We're going to hold your kids accountable. And finally, discipline. And discipline is also a word that sometimes can be scary. But discipline is sometimes doing the things that you don't want to do, right? It's doing the things that you don't want to do because you want to achieve something. So these are the three words that we focus on. We may not talk about them every day, but you sure as heck can understand that we're going to hold your kids accountable. And in some way, some fashion, these three words are going to make their way somewhere in our program on a daily basis. So how do we teach them? I said accountability. We have things like behavior checks. Taking a look at what your kids are doing during the week, all right? What our kids are doing during the week. Detentions, things like that, we'll talk about. We have an attendance policy, which is in there. We'll look at here in a minute. But it's about commitment, that attendance policy. It isn't for anything else other than teaching your kid commitment. And finally, we do things, weekly grade checks. We have a very good tutoring program. We'll talk about that here in a little bit. So yeah, we're gonna hold your kids accountable, but we're gonna reward them, all right? We're gonna reward them by earning what they get. So you can see here, we have the O all over the place, all right? That's the logo on our helmet, all right? The kids are gonna earn that. We have awards, we give t-shirts, we do a lot, but they have to work hard for it. And that's a big thing we're about. And we're going to celebrate all that stuff. If you work hard, you should be celebrated. At least that's what we try to do. We're going to celebrate it in front of the team. It isn't going to be a say, hey, man, good job. I mean, we're going to celebrate it in front of the squad. Because you have worked hard, you deserve that. We put it on social media. We're extremely active on social media. Coach Genders will talk about it. But I urge you to really follow that stuff because our kids are constantly being praised on social media, pictures, all kinds of things. And then we'll contact the parents. A lot of us in here probably have received some sort of correspondence from me, whether it's a postcard that I have written in my handwriting that looks like it's from a kindergartner, or a letter home, but we're gonna contact you guys and talk about what your kids are doing. So I said accountability, we have a behavior policy. I think it's important that we try to take away the gray area as much as we can when making decisions. I'll talk about what I mean by that. So 1 hour detention, regardless of what it is, your kid's gonna sit out for a quarter, okay? Regardless, it doesn't matter if the teacher's at fault or not,2 hour detention, half suspension. So sometimes that's tardies. Sometimes that's not necessarily the kid's fault. That's life, right? That's life. We live in Northwest Indiana where trains are everywhere. Things happen, okay? But that's the way it goes. In school, out of school, suspension, these things we can't tolerate. This is about respect, about doing things right. We're gonna hold you accountable to it, okay? I don't mean to come off like a hard ass, but that's just kind of why we're successful, because we hold teams accountable, okay? We have a whole attendance policy that is pretty in-depth. It's in your notebook, in that folder I gave you. It's pretty in-depth, there's a lot to it, so I'm not gonna cover everything. All right, I'm going to hit on some finer points, and you can look it over. If you want to have a discussion about it, absolutely. We'll talk about it later on. But basically what it is it's accumulation of points. And accumulation of points is based on things like you show up late to practice. Or you have to leave early from practice. Okay? Points begin to accumulate like that. You miss practice, you get points. With knowledge, without knowledge, you kind of understand what I mean by without knowledge. So if you don't contact the coach, if the kid doesn't contact the coach, that's without knowledge. That's like not showing up to work and not calling off. That's pretty bad, right? You get fired for things like that. Well, we're going to hold you accountable for things like that, okay? So, and then the consequences that we issue are based around these points. All right, so I may not be doing it justice, but you can look in there and you can read, and you'll see it begins to make sense. Some of the consequences are something as simple as just flipping tires. Okay, so you show up late, things happen, you get 50 yards of tire flips. You do your 50 yards, we'll never speak of it again. It'll be done and over with. Okay, there's things like obviously the suspension of quarter, two quarters from games. And then if there's a problem, then we start talking about removal of team. From the team. We've never had to do something like this on this attendance policy. To be honest with you, after a few weeks of it, it really doesn't become an issue anymore. So, and then obviously there's exceptions, right? So academics are number one here, and there is no, I'm not just saying that tongue in cheek, absolutely the most important. So you have things like tests, labs, things like that that run over. Yeah, for sure. You're not going to accumulate points. We're here for school. College visits, this doesn't necessarily apply to younger kids, but some of our juniors and seniors begin to attend games on Saturday, or they go visit colleges on Saturday. That's the kind of stuff we want. So that's exceptions. Other things that, just as long as you communicate, we make exceptions and stuff. And this is all based around commitment. Okay. Questions on that? Again, I know that doesn't explain everything, but like I said, it's in there. And we've had that document for a long time, kind of been revised and things, so I think that it makes sense. So, for instance, most of us could be JV players, probably all of us would be JV players. So if you accumulate, say, 2 points, okay? You miss without knowledge or what have you. You accumulate 2 points, you don't dress on Friday nights, and then you serve your suspension Saturday morning for JV games. So say it's a half suspension, you're not going to dress Friday nights, and then Saturday morning for your JV game, you're going to miss your half, and then you get to play, and then we won't talk about it anymore. It's over. Okay? Again, all in there. Missing school, we really, let's be honest, like it's not really acceptable. Now if you're sick, that's a whole different story. Missing school because you just don't want to go to school, that's not acceptable. That's the kind of stuff we're talking about. You can't just ditch school and then parents, we call them off. Don't do that. Force them to go to school, all right? When we don't go to school, we miss out on stuff at school. That's when problems begin to arise, right? So get to school. When you miss school, you will accumulate points. There isn't punishment, but you miss too much school, you may not be able to play on Saturday, okay? And let's be honest, if you miss 4 days of school because you're sick, chances are you shouldn't be playing on Friday or Saturday anyway because you were sick all week. Again, we're just trying to get kids to school. That's the bottom line. That's what this is all about. If you have any questions about school policy, like, how many hours can I come to school before I can play? You need to direct those kind of questions to the school. All right. Biggest thing about our attendance policy, just communicate. That's the biggest thing. Just communicate. So if we have a 1:15 practice, a 1:15 practice, don't text us or call us at 1:30 and say, Coach, I'm not going to be at practice. Obviously, you're not going to be at practice. Call us ahead of time. Text us ahead of time. Okay? Just like a job. Just like a career. You have to call when you're not going to show up to work, adults. Same thing. That's what we expect from kids. One of the things, back to this whole thing about accountability, your kids are going to call us. They're going to text us. They're going to come see us. We're not going to accept a phone call from the parent. Okay? Again, it's just part of growing up. Okay? It's part of growing up. So If a student's going to miss, he's going to text us. We have plenty of opportunities to communicate with coaching staffs. He'll text us, say, "Coach, I'm not going to be at practice today." That's it. Say thank you. That's all we're going to reply. We have the message. Good enough. Parents, you text us, "Hey, so-and-so's not going to be at practice today." We're not going to respond. And I'm not being a jerk. We're just trying to teach your kids a little bit of accountability. Now, if they don't have cell phones or something, then we have to make some arrangements. We'll talk more about that in the EB. Okay, questions on that? That's a lot I just gave you. But it's all in there. Okay, so take a look at that. If you're still confused, I will definitely have a conversation with you. At the end of there, we require parent and player signature. That way we're all on the same page that we understand the attendance policy, we all agree to it. If you don't agree to it, then we have to have a discussion. Okay? All right, that's that. I told you we're going to celebrate victories. We're going to celebrate good things. All right? We're hard on the kids, obviously, but we're going to celebrate the good stuff. So we talked about the O on the helmet. All right? We have a whole entrance dedicated to the O on our helmet. So it means a lot to us. That O is everywhere. It means a lot to us. So we're not going to just throw your logo on your helmet. You got to earn it. You got to earn it. And you do it by those three things right here. By being respectful in school. All right? No detentions. No in-school suspension, out of school. None of that. Okay? Commitment. Discipline. Those things. So this is how we earn it as a first-year player. In-school, out-of-school suspensions, if you get them by the midterm, you're not going to receive your logo on your helmet. Okay? So you're going to go out there, first-year kids, with a blank helmet on. You're going to go week one, week two, week three, week four. You're going to go several weeks without it. You're going to look different, but what we want you to understand is you have to earn being on our team. And you do that by doing these three things. Our discipline policy. At 6 weeks, if you got no in-school, no out-of-school suspension, no detentions, that's good. You have not accumulated over 3 points in those 6 weeks, that's good. And no D's or F's at the midterm, that's good. We're going to put your logo on your helmet, and we're going to celebrate the hell out of it. But if you don't meet some of these, you're just not going to get it at that point. It's harsh, but the reality is we're going to earn being a part of this. And because we are special because of stuff like this. Okay? And again, we start acting up. You get your O and you start acting up. We can take it off and we can start over at square one. Okay? And this is what I mean down here. Something that's worth something shouldn't come easy. If we just put your logo on your helmet, it means nothing to you. Earning that logo, that should mean something. Okay? And that's what I talk about by celebrating it. We'll put it on social media. All right? We give t-shirts for everything here. You work hard, you receive your t-shirts. We have helmet awards. We celebrate the heck out of our stuff. But we demand a lot. But we celebrate it. We buy food for everything. So your kids, we like to eat. So we look for reasons to buy food. So we do good stuff, we get rewarded with food. All right, we don't really eat the food. If there's leftovers, which is usually not. All right, but a pizza sometimes accidentally makes its way in our office. We devour like a couple of Raptors. But what I'm saying is, we're gonna celebrate the stuff. We're gonna, and it's because we work hard, okay?
I have a question.
Yeah.
Okay, the attendance policy.
Yes, ma'am.
So you're saying 3 points about midterm. Does that include the summer?
No.
Time?
So, great question. Now, I'm going to hit on that. Guys, the summer is unofficially football. So nothing officially starts till August 5th. Okay? I was going to hit on that a little bit later, but that's a great question, a great time to bring it up. August 5th is the first day of football. All that stuff we do in the summer and all that stuff that is preseason, technically nothing is mandatory during that time. Okay? So, you accumulate no points for missing practices. None of that stuff applies during the summer. August 5th, that is when football officially starts, and that is when all of our, I'm sorry, it's back a little bit, but that's where all our attendance policy begins, is August 5th. That is a great question. Does that kind of make sense? So August 5th, all that business starts. Other than that, you know, if you come and go during the summer, I mean, technically, we can't really say much to you, but we're going to ask, hey, I thought you were going to play football. What's going on? And we're going to at least want to know what's up, okay? We're not going to yell at you. We're not going to make you do punishments. We're not going to do anything like that. But, you know, you're beginning to make a commitment. We have to start honoring that commitment. But technically, August 5th. All right. Okay, we're going to talk a little bit more about academics. We'll get into some of that. I'm going to go through this part right now, we'll go from there. So, I don't know if you know, we're going to trimesters in high school. It's a huge difference than what we announced. I don't know if I let the cat out of the bag. Coach Reese, turn off, I'm just kidding, you don't turn off the camera, but.
It turned itself off.
Yeah. So that's what we're doing. We're going to have 5 classes, all right, at 70 minutes each. In order to be academically eligible, you have to pass 4, okay? I don't think ACC is going to apply to anyone in here, but if you go to ACC, then you have to pass all of them. ACC is a Hammond area university, so that probably doesn't apply to us. Study halls, teacher's aides, you know, you get an A in study hall, it doesn't count towards those 4 paths. So that some of that stuff doesn't really apply to the young kids, okay? So 6 weeks is a great check. From the school. So if you have if you didn't pass 4 classes at 6 weeks, they're going to remove you from the team. That's the school's policy. Okay, so you need to understand. Okay? All right, what else? How do we hold you accountable? Well, we do grade checks in and out of season. Okay? So every Monday in the weight room, we talk about your grades. Okay? We have Wednesday tutoring out of season. So, like today, we had a bunch of kids in tutoring today. We have a couple players that have graduated come back and help your son in tutoring in their subject areas. And so, like I said, we take it serious. During the season, we have tutoring on Fridays. So, Friday before we come out to the stadium, we're going to go. Some kids will go in the weight room. Some go to tutoring, and we're working to keep those grades up, all right? If you got a DRF, we're going to require you to go to tutoring. If you just want to go to tutoring because you want to get some extra help, that's great too, okay? So we take it serious. We do, all right? We have study tables. We're there to help. We're not just yelling at kids all the time. We're here to help. So we have study tables. We have people that help us out. That's what we're trying to do, is we're trying to get you eligible, we're trying to hold you accountable to stuff, that's what we're trying to do, we're trying to lend you a hand. So as I said, report cards are given out at 6 weeks, and that's going to determine your eligibility. Then again at 12 weeks, and that'll determine your eligibility. So this is all for next school year. Does that make sense? Did I get through that too quickly, or are we all good? Okay. It's never too early to start thinking about what you want to do after high school. And some of you might be saying, Jennings, I'm not even in high school yet. That might be the case. But I'm telling you, don't think about it when you're a senior. Okay? Then you're way too late. A few years ago, I had a student, a player, tell me he wants to go into nursing. He was a senior. Awesome. That's great. And you look at his GPA, and it was pretty bad. And it's sad that that's what that kid wants to do. But his GPA was so bad, there's nothing. No one's going to, I'm sorry, no one's going to take you with a GPA super low. Well, you know, that's a shame. So we're trying to catch them nice and early. All right, so we're going to talk about what you want to do after high school. We have already asked them. All right, we've already surveyed the kids. What do you want to do after high school? You're not even in high school yet. That's okay. May not know exactly what you want to do, but we're at least going to help you. You're going to at least think about what you're going to do after high school. You want to go into trades? Awesome. We'll help you. You want to go and be an electrical engineer? Awesome. We'll help you. We're going to do whatever we can. Okay? Football is just a a springboard for all kinds of other stuff. That just happens to be the medium we work in. So we're here to help, all right? We're not always yelling. We yell a lot, but we're not always yelling. All right, so here's some of the stuff regarding GPAs. Your GPA's not good, you have to have a great SAT. That stuff's in your notebook if you're interested in looking at that stuff, okay? NCAA website as well. I'm telling you, don't wait till your senior year and want to go to college. Let's get it done now, early, all right? All right. This is in there as well. Take a look at that if you're interested in looking at that. Okay, it's stuff for NCAA stuff. If you want to play college football, there's a place for anyone who wants to play college football, but you have to meet some requirements, so take a look at that. All right, I've done talking for a bit. Coach Davenport's going to take over and talk about our weight room program and nutrition. Obviously, I'm not the man to talk about for nutrition. Coach Davenport is. So we'll get it going. What's it? Down goes to the next one.
Yeah. All right, hey everybody. Chris Davenport. A lot of familiar faces here, a lot of new faces, which is awesome. All right, even one guy I played football with in high school. All right, I was a 1992 white and grad. Played three sports, football, wrestling, and baseball. All right, so we love guys who play multiple sports. All right, now to get on to the weight room. So goals are pretty simple for the weight room. Number one goal is make us as injury resistant as possible. The number two goal, which comes by trying to become injury resistant, we want to be as athletic as we can. So whatever your ceiling for athleticism is, that's what we want to reach. We don't want to be below the ceiling. We want to reach your athletic ceiling. So there's three guys that have heavily influenced everything we do in the weight room. The first guy, and I came across him many years ago, is Louis Simmons. He is the owner and operator and founder of the Westside Barbell Club in Columbus, Ohio. He trains the strongest human beings in the world. Many people have gone through his gym, have squatted over 1,000 pounds, okay? His thinking was revolutionary in the way of training. The United States was not very strong, not very good at stuff. So he, self-made man, self-taught man, decided these Russian guys do some amazing stuff. Went out, got a bunch of books from these Russian trainers, started learning. Gotta get used to that. But got all these books from these Russian trainers and started applying them in America. And I started reading everything he does. That's why I love his quote, "Please read." That's how he made himself reading and just revolutionized training. And that's how the first things I ever started doing were stuff from him. The next guy that I just came across recently, great fellow, Coach Tony Holler. He is the head track coach at Plainfield North High School in Illinois. He is a member of the Illinois Track and Field Hall of Fame. He is currently on his team training a kid named Marcellus Moore. If you're interested in seeing speed, Google Marcellus Moore, fastest kid in the state of Illinois. He's utterly amazing. Kid is so fast, he's 150 pounds, and he's been offered by the University of Michigan, University of Kentucky, and I forget who the other one was. They're 150 pounds, so you gotta be pretty fast like that. Tony was a longtime football and basketball coach, even won 53 state straight games as a freshman football coach. Biggest thing he did for me, author of Feed the Cats. Rethought everything that I do. His whole philosophy, to put it real quick in a nutshell, is to get in, do things at as high intensity as you can with as much rest as possible. That's why we come in twice a week. We run two sprints as fast as we can to try to get faster. A couple of the guys in here, they know that already because they've been coming in because they're part of the Whiting Middle School. But that is our goal, to become as fast as we possibly can. His great quote is, "Don't mistake activity for achievement." If you came and probably watched us in the weight room, you'd see a bunch of guys not doing a lot. That's because we value rest. So when it is your turn to do it, it is a maximum effort you are given. And number three Zach the Chant. He is a Texas Christian University baseball strength coach. He's been at TCU for, I think, about 8 or 9 years now. Author of Movement Over Maxes, which is a great book, and got me thinking a whole lot more how much more important is that we move correctly. Just being strong and not moving well doesn't do anything. We're not power lifters, we are athletes. So his book, his best quote is the name of his book, Movement Over Maxes. All right, like I've been saying, we train athletes. We got a couple of our athletes right here. Danny Canning on the left. He was a football and baseball guy. And Ashley Schrader on the right, volleyball and softball girl. I'm training athletes, not football players. I'm trying to make the best athlete we can, the sport coaches. So when I go out there and I'm a sport coach, that's when I'm teaching football. It's the baseball coaches, the basketball coach, volleyball coach. When they get them, that's when they teach that sport. We're trying to make it as explosive, as fast, and as strong as possible. That is going to benefit everything that you do. If your child consistently comes and walks through that door, they will become a better athlete. It's impossible for them not to. This was actually a tweet I stole from Zach the Chant, and he uses baseball as the example. But you have so much athletic ability. If your bowl of athletic ability is here, I don't care how much batting practice you take, I don't care how many pitches you throw, or if you want to talk basketball, I don't care how many jump shots you take. You can only grow that skill so much. That skill cannot outgrow your athleticism. So how do you become more skillful in your given sport? You grow your athleticism. That way you become a better football player. You become a better baseball player. You become a better wrestler. Can't grow the skill past your athleticism. So we need to grow the athleticism also. Talked about reducing injuries. We try to become strong because weak things break. We want to protect ligaments, tendons. And we do that by becoming strong. How do we become strong? We move properly. We will move properly. Once we master moving properly, we will start adding weight. And we will keep loading things. And we will load you and we will load you. As long as the movement looks good, we will continue to load you and you will continue to get stronger. As part of our injury prevention, we also use something called Reflex Performance Reset. It's fairly new. Tony Holler introduced me to it. It's kind of hard to explain, but the whole kind of thing behind it is everybody has these certain points on their body, triggers on their body that activate a certain muscle. And a lot of times some muscles aren't working, so you hear about hamstring injuries all the time, right? So these hamstring injuries might be because your glutes aren't firing when you're sprinting. So that strong glute muscle isn't working. All that load is ending up on your hamstring, and your hamstring ends up popping. So by doing these quick 5-minute warm-up drills, it helps to make us as injury resistant as possible. And since Mr. Allard's here, I'll give a quick example. Sucks to be the guy who knows me, right? So just a quick example for if your hamstrings aren't firing real well. Just bend over and reach down as far as you can.
Oh, jeez.
That's not too bad. All right, let's stand up. Now, the trigger point, it's kind of weird. The trigger point for the hamstrings is your lower back. So all we do is each kid on their own, they just basically do a little massage of their lower back. All right? All right, you got to give a tip later. $30 an hour. Now let's see how we're doing if we've loosened those up a little bit more. And we're able to get a little bit more now. Let's sit down. So that's the idea behind it, but that's for all the muscles. It activates them because your body, you know, it's a machine. And if one little link out of that machine isn't working, it can ruin the whole thing. So we want every link in the machine working. We talked about it, so we value movements over maxes. We value being as fast and as explosive as we can, but we're still going to be strong. class of 2019, we had 16 kids. I believe it was a dozen of them. So 12 of them who were in there regularly. All right. The average deadlift of all those guys was 405 pounds. All right. That's, and if you don't know what a deadlift is, that's a loaded up bar. You bend down, you stand up with it. So that's a small car. They average lifting. So you had, you know, a few kids a little bit under and a bunch of kids over. 405 pounds is a ton of weight. Same thing, those 12 guys, average bench press was 235 pounds. You get up to about 200 pound bench press, especially depending on how much you weigh, that's a lot of weight right there. That's a lot of weight. We just did some bench presses yesterday, in fact. We have four kids. We have clubs that we do. We have four kids getting to the 225 pound bench press club, and we had one getting the 300 pound bench press club. All right? We could be stronger than that if that's what we value. If we were a powerlifting team, that would be higher, but we're not. We're football players, we're wrestlers, we're basketball players, all right? We're athletes. So just a couple quick examples to touch on that. You're consistent, you come in. Thomas Knight, football, basketball player. That's him here on the left. I know he looks a lot different. So the little tiny fella on the left, and I wish I had his body weight. He's probably 140 pounds right there. Since freshman year, he could bench press 135 pounds, which is actually pretty good for a freshman. Could only deadlift 185 pounds. He was slow as could be. Ran a 20-yard dash in just over 3 seconds. And he was just under 6 seconds in the 40. That's slow. All right, if you don't know what that means, that's slow. Now, the guy with the giant arms on the right is the same person. Now he's a senior. If what we were worried about was being as strong as possible, he probably would have benched 300 pounds, but he was almost there. Deadlifting in the mid fours, flying on the 20, and at a 4.6 in the 40. That's bad. Probably 135 pounds on the left. He's about played the season at about 205. So that's 205 pounds running a 4.640. That's fast. That's fast. That's big and that's fast. My one other example, I used to, and I could have used any of these guys that are graduating this year. I just had real good pictures of Tom, and I had real good pictures of Joel for before and after. So they got to do it. So Joel, I forgot, so I went back looking at pictures. He was a little bit pudgy as a freshman. A little bit pudgy, extremely weak, could only bench 115 pounds, slow as can be. Now his senior year, he looks like he's been chiseled out of granite, can bench 245 pounds, and he can run real fast. Basketball, football, and baseball, three sports. Made the time to get in the weight room. Made the time. That's the only way that happens. So off-season training, and right now when I refer to off-season training, that's football off-season. So some of these guys, it might be in-season for them because they could be playing basketball, baseball, what have you. Well, we train Monday through Friday. The biggest reason we bring the kids in Monday through Friday is we could get away with 3 days a week, but we kind of like to see the kids every day. It's better. That 3 o'clock to like 5 o'clock period, that's when bad stuff happens. And so you know what? They come in after school, they spend 50 minutes with us. Those kids who ain't doing the right things, they're already on their way out of these guys' lives and doing whatever the heck it is they do, and our guys are doing the right things. So that's really the main reason I like Monday through Friday. So every day but Wednesday, Wednesday's early release for any of the new people, so they get out early on Wednesday, so we don't open in the morning on Wednesdays. Other than that, we're open in the morning and the afternoon. So if you're in a multiple sport athlete, you have two opportunities to get in there. So no real excuse not to show up. Okay. In-season training, and this is for our in-season training as football players, but then if I have a guy who's also basketball, baseball, what have you, goes for them. And this is how we train year-round. Minimum effective dose. We train like 45 minutes. We're not in there a long time. Okay, those three guys, that's what I learned for. You get in, you do the right things, and you get your butt out. All right, you see a lot of people who just love, and they grind, and they like to use the word grind, and look at how much sweat I put on the floor. That really shows I work. Well, we're trying to be athletes. We're not trying to lose weight or be on the Biggest Loser or anything else. So there's a great quote I love. Any fool can make another fool tired. And I've seen a ton of these trainers. That's all they do. They're fools that make other fools tired. That's not what we do. I want kids to leave and either go play on their basketball team, go play on their baseball team, or you know what? If they only play football, that's fine too. But they feel like going out and doing whatever it is they do. Pick up basketball. Heck, tag, if kids even play tag anymore, I don't know. Probably not, right? But I want them to go out and feel good. The idea is to leave there feeling better than they came in. All right, that's how you make athletes. Beating a kid down, that's ridiculous to me. So any fool can make another fool tired. So I definitely don't want to be that fool. All right, nutrition, we're almost done here. Nutrition, it's real simple for kids this age. Eat a lot of things with protein, drink a lot of water, a ton of water. It's pretty simple. Lots of protein, lots of water. All them pops and sugary drinks, including Gatorade, stay away from that junk. It adds nothing to you. It adds absolutely nothing to you. Candy adds nothing to you. These horrible cereals, Fruity Pebbles and everything else. You are better off going and getting an Egg McMuffin that at least has some protein and some quality stuff in it than Fruity Pebbles with all its sugar and other junk in it.
That's why I look the way I do, because I eat a lot of
Fruity Pebbles. Lots of Fruity Pebbles. We should have been eating McMuffins.
I wish you told us that growing up.
But that's what these kids need. They need the proper fuel. Okay, they're growing like weeds. Hormones are working, they're lifting weights. You've seen the pictures of those other guys. That's what ends up when you eat the right things and you come in and do what I tell you to do. Sleep is the last thing. Super important. The three guys I talked about first, they made me realize how important and how fragile the central nervous system is. If we beat up that central nervous system, we cannot perform. So everybody knows in here how it kind of feels. You're kind of sluggish. You don't feel like you can move real well. That's because your central nervous system is beat up. I've read a few things where they don't even believe 8 to 9 hours is enough. Right? The more sleep, the better. Coach Howler often says when I was at a speed camp last year, just bending his ear, he'd ask the kids, he's like, oh, when'd you go to sleep? Kid didn't run very well. If you went to bed an hour earlier next time, I bet it'll be a little bit better. And I can tell when kids, I got that timer, I'm timing sprints, I know when kids haven't been sleeping, all right? It shows up in a hurry. Try to get your kids to put those phones away, all right? Them things, just because they're going to bed doesn't mean they're going to sleep, all right? Get them phones out of their hands, get them to sleep. That is how they're going to recharge. That central nervous system, it's like a 9-volt battery charges that thing. 9-volt batteries don't last real long, so you gotta get that sleep to recharge that sucker. Last thing we got, quick video, just kind of show you what we do in the weight room. All right, we got all kinds of different athletes. We got football players, we got volleyball players, we have softball players. We have a huge group of athletes in this. And every month, till our actual season in August starts, I make a weight room video. So if you go search Oiler Weight Room on YouTube, you're going to see all this stuff. We got our young guys. That's an incoming freshman. That's a softball player. Simple injury prevention here for the hips. These kids are in school sitting 8 hours a day. Their hips are terrible. All right, we gotta make sure they work. You can't jump high if you can't land right, like you saw Morgan coming off the bench there. See, the thing is, we work on mechanics of running and Al outrunning quite a bit. You'll never find a coach that says they got kids who are too fast. That doesn't exist. That's a softball player there, and she can move a little bit. Hamstring exercise, unbelievably hard. Michael's pretty good at it. Baseball player right there. Couple of young middle school guys even coming up, working speed. I've been doing them since 2015, so you can get a look at what goes on in LA.
All right, guys. Obviously, weight room is a big part of our success, and I'm telling you, there's no one better than Coach Davenport, and I'm not just saying that because he's standing here. I really believe that since he's come on board, our strength and conditioning, our speed, and our health, and just he's impacted a lot of our program. And so I'm telling you, we need to listen to the guy. And if you think you know something, you don't until you talk to Chris, and then he'll teach you something. So that's that. All right, I think a big concern, I want to make sure that I address it, is player safety. First off, any questions about anything? There's been a lot of stuff thrown at you. We're recording it, we'll put it online, you can take a look at it. And then, like I said, I'll stick around. So if you got questions or something, we can handle that. Okay, player safety, and I think is a big, important topic. And you know, there's a lot of stuff in the news. Some of it's true, some of it's not. So I think we need to address it. It is, on the field, it is by far our number one priority. And again, I don't really say anything without meaning it. And it is. You saw all those coaches. We have a ton of coaches for a reason. It isn't like I just want a big coaching staff hanging around me. We're trying to keep your kids safe. The more coaches we have, the better we can protect your kids. Now, again, it's a contact sport. And things do happen. But when I got 12 guys with us, we can look at a ton of individual aspects of tackling and blocking and stuff. So we have a big staff for a reason, and it's to help keep your kids safe. Our staff, every single one from the top down, receives multiple certifications through the National Federation of High School Sports. And meaning they have to go and they have to take quizzes and they do online modules for everything regarding concussions, sudden cardiac arrest, heat illness, equipment stuff, proper tackling, bullying, hazing. I mean, there's a lot of stuff that we have to do. It's multiple hours. So we're very well versed in a lot of this stuff, okay? We're also trained in the USA football's tackling system. We call it Heads Up. We do it. Our middle school program does it, and a Pop Warner program does it. So it is the same language from beginning to end. We love it. We use it for everything, and it just keeps the head out of the tackle. We're never going to tell you to put your head down and put your head on the ball, that kind of stuff. We're here to keep the kids safe. It's a whole shoulder tackling system, okay? If you want to look at it, it's at usafootball.com. All right, you can go look at the drills that they do online. We do every single day, or nearly every single day. Okay? I always say this isn't the 1980s, 1990s no more. So what was good then is definitely not good for us now. Not saying that it wasn't effective, I'm just saying that there is better out there. At least we feel like there's better. As Coach Davenport said, just read a little bit. You start to learn. Okay, that's what we did. All right, we became smarter. So we don't have 3.5 hour practices. That's when those hamstrings and things start to go. When you're out there for three and a half hours, we're not going to do it. Okay? I played in that system, and I coached early on in that system. I was tired. Now, I'm not exactly a pillar of athletic ability anymore, but standing around for 3.5 hours sucks. Okay? As a player, that sucks. All right? I've been through that. We don't do live tackling every day. We hardly ever do live tackling, I'll be honest. We're not going to get out there and smash each other in those videos that you see all the time online. We don't do it. We want you healthy. We want you playing at your peak performance, at your peak. On Fridays, who cares if you can smash someone on a Wednesday? That don't mean anything. Okay, it's about Fridays, all right? So we're going to keep you healthy as much as we can. We're never going to get out there and just run to run. We're not going to condition. We're not going to just say, go run laps. We don't do that stuff. It's not 1999 no more, okay? We don't do that stuff. That's where the whole feed the cat stuff comes in. Fresh is better, all right? That's what we feel like, all right? That's what we feel is better. That's what people a lot smarter than us say, so that's what we follow, okay? We're going to be out there a couple hours, and then we're going to get out. So 2 hours. 2 hours and 10 minutes is probably where we're going to be at, and then we're going to get out of there, okay? Wednesdays, in the season, we'll have pads on. We'll go full pad, or actually shoulder pads and helmets. On Wednesdays. The rest of the week, we're going to be in helmets only. We're going to keep the kids fresh. That is the goal. So when we're playing in the sectionals and the regionals, we're feeling as good as we can. Okay? In the preseason, the summer stuff, we'll be in shoulder pads on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And I'm talking about that. Okay? So we're not going to go out there and smash. We used to do that. We would go out there on the first day of live tackling and put like a senior with a freshman. And try to kill kids. We're not going to toughen them up, all right? We're not going to toughen your kid up. That's not what we're here for, okay? So all that stuff is garbage. You see it on Twitter, leave it. It don't belong in our pro. It don't belong in football, I'll be honest. All right? So that's the deal, okay? Now, as I said, it's a contact sport. Things do happen, all right? We have a licensed athletic trainer who's phenomenal. She's been with us for 8 years at Danny Pillen. Okay, she's a Hedwish girl, went to St. John the Baptist. She loves working here. We love having Dan. We have such a good relationship with her. She works. We contract out to the Community Care Network, and they have a whole concussion clinic and a place that she works at during business hours. And then after, she comes out to us. She's really good. She's tough on the kids. What I guess I'll tell you is we have a trainer for a reason. We pay that place good money. If your kid comes home with an ache, don't run to the ER, okay? ER, first off, is expensive, and we all need more money in our pocket. We don't make enough money to be just throwing around, all right? So there's bumps and bruises are going to happen. Don't run off to the doctor. Have Danny look at it. We pay her. You might as well use her, okay? Say, Danny, you know, the next day you come in, Danny, and you know, I got hit in the arm. It hurts pretty good, you know, when I touch it. She'll look at it, and she feels that, you know, yeah, there's something more serious. Then we'll make arrangements. Now, let me preface this. We're not telling you not to take your kid to the ER. Okay? So if you feel like the kid deserves it, take him. That's your business. I'm just saying we have a person who's extremely capable of handling some minor stuff and some other stuff, ligaments and things like that, we can help you with. But just running to the ER doesn't, you know what the ERs do? Make an appointment with your primary, you get to your primary's gonna say, you know what, let's rest for 6 weeks. Rest what? What is wrong with me? 6 weeks rest, okay? Danny is gonna at least work with it. She'll rehab you. If it's nothing serious. Now, if it's serious, then we're going to send it to you, doctor. Okay, so I hope we kind of understand it. I'm not telling you to not take your kid to the ER. By all means, that's what you want to do. I'm just saying, we have a licensed trainer who's been here a long time, who has a lot of experience and knows what's going on. Utilize her. And then if we'll rehab you, we'll sit you out of practice, we'll do what we gotta do to get you healthy. Your safety and your kid's safety is by far our number one priority, all right? But it doesn't do anyone any good to go to a place and tell you to sit out for 6 weeks for a contusion. It's a bruise. That has happened.
Right.
Okay, yeah.
And remind the kids to tell the coaches and people before they go home.
Yes, that's a good point. Thank you, Coach. So, yeah, like sometimes we'll leave practice, we don't really know something happened. All right? And then they go home and tell the parents, and then the parents kind of like, you know, what happened? And we don't know about it. Tell us. All right? We're not going to yell at you for getting hurt. Tell us so we can help you. Okay? All right, hey, let's go see Danny. We'll get this thing figured out. We'll look at you. If we need to go to a doctor, she'll make a phone call home. Hey, you should take so-and-so to the doctor. That, you know, it looks like it could be broke. Okay? But you have to communicate. I'll tell you what, that is all of life is communication, but especially in our football program. Just talk to us so we can help. All right? We'll talk more about communication, but again, we have Danny. I urge you to utilize her. Okay? Questions on that? All right. With safety also comes equipment. I think that's important. I'll kind of hit through this fast because I know it's getting late. We all got things to do. And we're probably hungry and all that other stuff. Hey, what we provide, we're going to give you kids shoulder pads. All right? We're going to give you a nice expensive helmet, $350. It's a good helmet. It's by Rydell. Our helmets have a 10-year, not ours. They all have a 10-year life cycle. All right? So that helmet, yep, 10 years sounds like a long time, but every year we send that helmet out to be refurbished. What do they do when they're refurbished? Well, they inspect it. All right, they're going to look for cracks, for stresses, for any sort of defects, anything like that. If a helmet remotely could possibly be damaged, that helmet is removed from the program. We don't see it again. Okay? Our helmets are inspected by a licensed company, so it isn't me just sitting in the shed looking at helmets. All right, we pay a company to come and look at our helmets and determine whether or not the helmet is safe. If it's safe, they'll recondition it, repaint it, and so on, and then send it back to us. Okay? After 10 years, that helmet is no longer in use, and it's gone. All right, we have had kids buy their own helmets in the past. I'm just going to tell you to make sure they get painted green. All right? We have beautiful helmets. Just use ours. $340 on ours. Okay. We're going to provide you with the pads and the girdles, okay? So a three-pad girdle. Basically, it's your hip pads and your butt pad. The girdles are old, and by old doesn't mean that they're unsafe. Old as in many people have wore those girdles, okay? And we do wash stuff, but many people have worn those girdles. So I recommend you go out and buy a nice five-pad girdle. We'll talk more about that, okay? But we'll give you the necessary pads. So you don't need to go out and spend hundreds of dollars on stuff. We're going to give you your basic equipment, okay? And obviously uniforms and pants. That's stuff that we loan to you. This is all on loan, by the way. You don't need to keep your helmet, all right? So, yep, we'll provide that stuff for you, okay? So what do you need? Well, your kids need to spend a few bucks, or you guys need to spend a few bucks. We call it a player pack. It's $65. In your folder, there is a sheet for your player packet. You get our team shirt. You get a team short. You get a wrist coach for plays. You get a practice jersey. You get a laundry bag. Okay. So for $65, which is a pretty good deal, we're not making any money off of this. This is not a fundraiser. This is base cost for the stuff. You buy it online. The website's there. Fire it up with your credit card, and all that stuff will get delivered nicely to your kid, okay?
And it's due by?
And that's in another sheet, but it is due by, no, you're good, you're good. It's due the 26th of May, yes ma'am, thank you, okay? 26th of May. So that's not a lot of time, but that's what it is, okay? Questions on, yes?
I have a question. I'm trying to order the practice jersey.
Okay.
And when I click on it, it is now telling me coach will give you the sizes. It's not letting me.
Don't worry. Yeah, so when he gets assigned a jersey size, it comes a size that will fit the person. So you can't even order at all?
Okay, so I can think about the jersey because it's saying that we should order.
Okay, so that's a problem with the company.
I reached out to them today and they said that they're going to get in touch with you and they put that little note in there.
Okay.
So when we all see it,
all right, my apologies. Yeah.
That it's going to come from you. So everybody is trying to buy it.
So okay.
It said it's going to come from you.
Gotcha.
And you're going to get the numbers.
Thank God for Jan.
And then they're going to tell us, go order it. So we can't order by the 26th unless you have numbers.
So what they're going to do is they're going to send me all the jerseys regardless. So they'll get one way or another. So let me clarify that and see what's going on. And then, thank you for that. Thank you for that. Okay, I appreciate that. So obviously the jersey thing is a problem. I've had a few people ask me about that. Okay, so thank you. Questions, anything else on the panel? Okay. Now, you may be wanting some fresh gear, like some cool shirts and stuff, parents, and some hoodies, and whatever else. We'll have all that stuff in June, okay? Right now, it's just a player packet, just to get this stuff ordered in it, okay? All the cool gear that we get, jackets and hoodies and sweats and all the other stuff, we'll have that stuff a little bit later on, okay? So again, later on in June, we'll post on Facebook, hey, Spirit store is open, and then you go buy all that cool stuff, okay? Right now, it's very base stuff, and it's for players, okay? It's not to say you can't go and buy an extra t-shirt for you. That's fine. I don't have a problem with that. I'm just saying all the cool stuff will be in June, okay?
One player packet is a laundry bag. What are the players responsible for?
So it says required, one of the laundry bags. So basically, that's just the stuff that all their stuff goes in. When we go to away games, kids can put their cleats and stuff in there as well, take all that stuff. But so the laundry bag is required, and I know you said, well, can't we just use a duffel bag? Well, we like to make that one look the same. That's what we at least try to do. Okay, so it's $10, and it's listed as required. Good? Okay. There's optional cleats online. We make, I'm not telling you have to buy cleats. The company is... just offering cleats. They asked if they can put their cleats online. Yep. Not a team shoe. You're not required to buy Adidas shoes. Nothing. It is there. Do what you want with it, okay? So, like I said, it is nothing cleat-wise are required. You can go out and buy your own cleats. Completely up to you. Do whatever you want. You can buy an arm, you can buy Nike, you can buy the Adidas that are up there. You can do whatever you want. Does that make sense? Okay. All right, so for a turf, we kind of do the molded cleats. Those are pretty common. They're a little bit cheaper, the molded cleats. As your kid gets older, I think a pair of molded and a pair of removable cleats would probably be beneficial. So the removable cleats, when we start playing, in bad weather as they get to be juniors and seniors, I think is worth the investment. You don't have to do it now, all right? Molded cleats are fine. I'm just saying in the future, it might be something to think about adding to your kid's shoe game there. So we also have used cleats. So money's tight. If you don't want to spend money on a pair of cleats or what have you, you're unsure if your kid's going to stick it out for 4 years, we have, and I'll tell you what, there's some nice ones in there because kids use them a few times and then discard them. So our shoe room is back there, and unless something has changed, all those shoes should still be in there. All right, I don't go in there because it smells in that shoe room, so I just stay out of there. All right, I also recommend a 5-pad girdle. So a 5-pad girdle's got your hips, the butt pad. Oh, jeez, there we go, technology. So a 5-pad girdle is the hip pads, thigh pads, and a butt pad. We offer it online. Okay, not required, it's optional. It's like $23, I think it is. It's pretty good, it's by Tag. So you're welcome to buy that. It's online, and it's not on that sheet I gave it because I don't want anyone to get confused. So it's online on our website, you're welcome to buy that. We have those girls I told you about that were worth for 20 years. All right, I would invest, but that's just me, okay? Completely optional though. I'll give you a girl if you want. If you don't like what they offer online, you can go buy your own girdle at Dick's Sporting Goods or something and pay $50. That's up to you. Or you can buy this one for $23. And I'm not making any money off of it, so I'm just trying to help. Questions on anything that your kid needs? So we're not telling you to go out and spend hundreds of dollars. If your kid tells you we have to buy these cleats for $110, that kid is lying to you. All right? We're not telling anyone. In fact, we're offering free cleats. $110 is a lot. All right, so there it is. These are the five things that are required. Okay? Buy them by May 26th at 11:59 because May 27th, 12 a.m., it's off the hook. I don't know what happens after that. We've got to figure out. And your stuff will be delivered around June 17th. All right? I'll give you a phone number. If they're not here by June 17th, you can call and complain to them because I have nothing to do with it. I'm not back there printing stuff. Okay? So that's the company we deal with. You can call them. But June 17th, and they're usually around that time. So.
And it comes here.
And it comes here, and it'll come in a nice packet, and I'll throw it to your kid, and he'll have it. Okay? Questions on player packets, $65, it's pretty cheap. And we get some decent stuff. This is a nice Adidas shirt. It'll look good. All right? Okay. There's a lot of stuff. But I want you to leave here feeling good. Schedules. You got a summer schedule in your folder. It looks intimidating. And that's only because we're pretty organized. So everything is planned to a T. All right? So you can take a look at it. We start day after St. John people, I'll talk to you in a second. I'm good. We start the day after Memorial Day. That's because here at Whiting we start like June or July 5th. Of school. So we start pretty early. Okay. So day after Memorial Day, we start our summer stuff. St. John the Baptist people, you can come along when you guys get out at the end of June. Okay? So it's there, our summer schedule. We also have our summer schedule at whitingfootball.com. It's a website we keep up. It looks pretty good. There's a lot of good stuff there. I recommend taking a look. So our schedule is there. So, changes to that schedule are rare, all right? So if your kid tells you, well, we don't have practice today, that kid is just lying, all right? We have practice, and barring a natural disaster, we're going to be, we'll get together that day, all right? Never do we say, well, we're just going to take today off. We never, ever, 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 ever say that, okay? If it's not on the schedule, if it's on the schedule, it's happening. That's basically where I'm getting at. Okay? Now, changes may occur. So we may say, well, instead of meeting in the Vixenhagen Championship room, which happens to be at our gym, that's our weight room, instead of meeting there, we may say, well, meet us out at the stadium. So if there is a change, a minor change, we'll be communicated through social media. All right? We'll talk about social media in a minute. We have Remind, we have Facebook, we have Twitter, we have Huddles. We have plenty of opportunities for you to see a schedule change. I'm going to tell you, they are very, very rare. Okay? We're not a program that just makes up stuff as we go. All right? We're not going to just change the date. We don't ever do that. So this stuff is planned multiple weeks ahead of time for a reason. That way coaches can schedule their stuff. You guys can schedule your stuff, and you go from there, okay? So on the calendar, if it says VSCR, you're gonna meet us at the gym at door 11. If it says the stadium, that is here. We'll come here. Our doors open always, 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 a half hour ahead of schedule. So if it says 1:15, you can bet that a coach is there about 12:45, okay? On time is late, all right? A lot of us have punched clocks through the years. You know you can't punch your clock on the dot. Some of you may race there and punch on the dot, but you're really supposed to be there ahead of time. On time is late, so if we're saying we're on the field at 1:15, you best get your behind here early. Get dressed, because at 1:15 we're starting. Like today we start at 6 on the dot. That's 6:01. Not 6:04, 6 o'clock on the dot, that's how practice is ran. That's how the weight room is ran. All right, you show up late, that's an issue, OK? Okay? All right. Questions on that summer schedule? Now, there's a lot of cool stuff on that summer schedule. So let's look at some of those dates. May 20, I got this in there. All right? I'm doing all the work for you guys. No excuses. May 26th, that's when that package store closes. Okay? May 28th, equipment handout. We're going to meet here. We'll hand out all our cool stuff. St. John kids, you're going to miss out. June 7th, Coach Cannon retirement party. We've got to celebrate the guy who was here for like 70 years, so we're going to celebrate him. That's out at the park. Check it out on social media. June 14th, it's a Friday. We don't really go Fridays. But June 14th, we have what we call the Big Man Challenge. We bring in some schools from around the area, and the linemen have it like it's a bunch of competitions and stuff. Young guys, we'll see how we fit into that. So I'm not saying you're going to have to be here. That's one thing that it's kind of iffy. So that's June 14th, so just keep that in mind. June 15th is our car wash. We're going to talk more about our car wash. That's a Saturday. Okay? Lafayette Big Man Challenge. This applies to none of us in here. We go down to Lafayette. We compete against the biggest schools in the state. Last year we finished second. With the likes of like Maryville, Lafayette, Jeff, these are phenomenal schools that we go down there and we compete with. That is by invite only, so we're only gonna take 5 to 10 kids down there. But it's a pretty special deal for us, we're pretty proud of it, so that's on that schedule. July 30th to the 7th, that's moratorium, we don't do anything. No football related stuff, nothing. We can't even talk to the kids, that's by the IHSAA, okay? July 8th, physicals are due. So if you don't have a physical by July 8th, this is an important one, guys. That's when you want to highlight. If you don't have a physical by July 8th, that is an issue. Your kid cannot practice. And we're not going to say, oh, you know what, just we'll get it next week. I'm not going to put myself at liberty or these guys by letting you practice without a physical. So hands down, you have to have your physical. July 12th, we'll talk more about that. Nino Barbosa is a senior graduate this year. He's playing an all-star game down in Indy. We're possibly looking at taking the kids down there for the day, okay? We'll talk more about that. We have a scrimmage July 18th. We'll go down to Highland. And then August 5th, first day of football. I printed that out. That's for you, put it on your fridge, okay? Questions? Hang with me, guys, hang with me. Here is our football schedule. I'm not gonna really go through it. It's online, it's everywhere, it's in your folder, okay? Big one up there, I'm pretty excited for. We're gonna take a 5.5 hour trip down to Evansville Modern Day. Or actually to Evansville Wrights. And we're gonna play Modern Day. Modern Day is a school our size, phenomenal program. The guy's been there for 27 years. The stadium is beautiful and it looks like an NFL stadium. Okay? Google it, Evansville Modern Day Stadium. And you're gonna see what it looks like. We play a doubleheader, we play at 4 o'clock, and then another team will play after us. Awesome. We're gonna get in a charter bus, we're gonna travel down in style. Pretty cool deal. All right, and then the rest of it is our normal teams. Okay, so that's week two, right, no matter day. So that's a Saturday, so we're gonna leave nice and early, we'll get back nice and early, we're not staying the night. Okay, so our in-season practice schedule and such is not finalized. So I don't have a very detailed schedule of that done yet. We're still working through that. Few things that you need to know. We'll have that schedule by the end of June, probably well before that. As I've been saying, August 5th is the first official day. Saturday, August 10th, we're practicing. All right, that's the reason I'm telling you is because people like to get away that Saturday before school starts. We're practicing. We practice every single day after school. We don't say, oh, I'm going to take today off. We're always after school. We're going to go to about 5, not about. We will go to 5:15. So if we say 5:15, we are off the field at 5:15. We're not going to extend it to 5:30. We'll go to 4 to 6 today. 5:15. We have a lot of kids that come from elsewhere that need to get rides. I'm sure at some point in your lives, adults, you have had to sit there and wait for a coach to end practice. It's crap. We don't do it. So if we say 5:15, your kid will be off the field at 5:15. Now, if he leaves the locker room at 6 o'clock, you need to yell at your kid. All all right? Because he's in here jacking around, doing whatever kids do in locker rooms, all right? But 5:15, we'll be off the field, okay? Saturday, JV. So we have stuff going on Saturdays. JV game, okay? That is our big JV day. So we're all first-year players. We're all probably JV kids in here. You're going to be playing on Friday or on Saturday mornings. All right, coach will talk more about that. We're usually here about 8 to 11 in that time range. We'll talk more about that when your summer schedule comes out. Labor Day, we practice in the morning. Labor Day, we practice in the morning. But coach, it's Labor Day. Sure is. We practice in the morning. All right, we're going to labor on the field. Fall break. That's first week of sectionals. We practice. Coach, fall break. Yep, we're going to be out there practicing. All right? Friday, we actually have a week 9 game. We'll be here at 3 o'clock. So if you want to go do something in the morning Fridays, and then your kid will expect you to be here by 3 o'clock Friday afternoon. That Monday of fall break, the 21st, we practice. Practice in the morning, get your kid done, get out and go do what you want to do. Okay? I'm just telling you ahead of time because obviously we've had issues in the past. So there it is. All right, questions on any of that? So this is a great segue into social media because we communicate a ton on social media. All right, time's getting long here, so we'll finish this thing up as quickly as we can.
Keep it nice and short for you guys. Real quick, if you're on Facebook, look us up, Wide Open Winters High School Football Program. I try and post something at least 3 to 4 times a week. Right now we're doing every Friday, we do Flex Friday, so we're kind of highlighting everything that's happening in the weight room, taking pictures, kind of showing off guys' accomplishments. As we start getting nearer to the season, we're going to start doing kind of coaches' profiles. We're going to be taking kids' profiles, we're going to introduce you to the juniors, the seniors, and we're going to start working our way kind of backwards, introducing new guys to the program. One of the other things we want to do, if your kid, hey, the boys don't like to kind of tell us all the time either. If something's happening with your kid that that you want us to know about that we can share, we want to share it. Let us know, let me know, let Coach Brett know, and we want to highlight these kids. They're getting, you know, at the end of the year or end of the semester, AB honor roll kids, we want to get them out there. We want to show off what you guys are doing, okay? So if there's something going on, let us know. We would love to highlight it. We're on Twitter. Everything that goes through Facebook always gets posted on Twitter. At Whiting Football, Coach Davenport, Oiler Weight Room. That's the Vixa Hagen stuff. We'll also be going through Remind. Remind is a program that's set up so that way we can send out one text message and it goes to everybody that signed into it. So that way we're not just getting, so that way you're not getting one of those big mass texts and everybody's replying to it and you're listening to everybody's nonsense. We have the Fix the Hagen Room, that's for player updates. So guys coming in, jump on that if you're on. If you're gonna be going to the weight room, obviously you should be. So get on that, so that way if coach has any changes or anything that happens, it goes through that. The Whiting FL, that's for parents updates. Any, we will not change the schedule willy-nilly. Kid comes home and says, we don't have practice. You're gonna get a remind about it. It's gonna be posted on Facebook. It's gonna be posted on Twitter, okay? If they come home and say something like that, they're BSing. So parents for that. Then we have the Oilers JVF. That's for JV people. So probably pretty much everybody in here. Should something change as far as sometimes, you know, Saturday mornings can be a little bit iffy. Sometimes we'll change times because of fields get wet or whatever.
Bus breaks down.
Bus break. Yeah, we've had bus breakdowns. We've had all kinds of problems. This way, same idea. I can get a mass text out to everybody at once rather than sending it to the whole team because obviously like, the juniors and seniors are going to be sitting here doing film. WhitingFootball.com has all of the schedules, has all, kind of all of the same info that we're going to be posting on here.
That sheet is in your folder.
Yeah.
So you don't have to write anything down. Yeah, that's all in.
And all you have to do with remind, so you're going to just, in your text, you're going to send it to 81010. And then you're going to put either at Vixa, the
Fix the hide.
Fix the hide, Whiting FO or Wheeler's JVF.
You'd sign up for all of those. Guys, JV guys, I would definitely get into that. JV parents do the same thing. We're not going to make any changes unless it goes through that. JV, obviously I'm a JV coach. We practice with the varsity. So you guys, young guys, you're coached by myself, Coach Dabbs, Coach Reese, Coach Jennings. We go through everything they kind of go through, and then we'll have our own little side sessions. We'll be going through our plays, walking through our stuff, and kind of start getting guys where they belong. I'm going to be honest with you. Young guys, you're kind of the punching bags to start off with, okay? You're kind of taking those reps against the big guys that are taking those first series reps. Practice during the week can be kind of miserable. So Saturday mornings, we're going to have fun going out, flying around. That's our time to kind of go out and practice what we've been doing all week, okay? Where we get to go out and we get to go hit some guys and we get to kind of have a little bit more fun. Saturday mornings are going to be a lot of fun. For guys that have been with me, I did the middle school program for the last 4 years. I've always tried to, have a good time with you guys. Same thing is going to apply on Saturday mornings. We're going to go out there, we're going to fly around, we're going to have a good time, and we're going to hopefully win some games this year. I'm super excited about the guys that we have coming up. I think we've got a pretty good JV squad, and I know as a coaching staff we've talked about, we're pretty excited about having you guys, and I think as you guys continue to grow, if you guys put in the work, we could do some good stuff this year. Do some really good stuff. So, any questions during the course of the season, I'm always available. Come talk to me. That's really all I got.
All right, I'm going to try to get through this because I know people want to go. All right, so what's next? I got a to-do list in there for you. I even put the little boxes so you can put a check in. You're a list checker. All right, my wife is, so everything's list. It's ridiculous. May 26th, get those packets purchased by May 26th. We got a fundraise. We got all kinds of cool stuff. Stuff is not cheap. So we do fundraise in your packet. You got a fundraise, you got an envelope full of car wash tickets. There's four, it says cards, it should say cars. You got four $5 tickets for cars and four $8 tickets for SUVs and such. All right, go out and pre-sell that stuff. June 15th is our car wash, so we try to do a big pre-sale. Why do you think we do pre-sale with car wash? So when it rains, we make money. All right, we have to, okay? We got to raise funds, okay? It's just, our school does a phenomenal, this is being recorded, so I got to say this. Our school does a phenomenal job of getting us great equipment, great uniforms. I mean, we're rocking some Adidas jerseys this year. That's on film. That's going to happen. So we're wearing Adidas. So they do a good job of outfitting us. That other stuff, we have to fundraise for. So like that cool banner right there, that's a lot of money. Okay? So we got to pay for that. All right. What else you got to do? You got to get a physical. Now, if your current physical on, say you have a current physical on file. If that thing is dated before April 1st, it's going to expire July 1st. So if you got a physical like in February, some of the Whiting guys, all right? In February, a lot of things are going to expire July 1st. You need to go out and get another one. If your physical is dated after April 1st, you're good. You're good for football, this for the 2019-20 school year, for football, basketball, baseball, whatever else that you do. Okay? If you're unsure, because that's kind of confusing, if you're unsure, you can ask me. And if you say I turned one in, I'll research it, make sure that you did, and let you know. Okay? I told you, we're not going to go, I'm going to get my, I got my physical, I just got it at home. I got to have it in hand, it's got to be properly signed. When all that's happened, then you can participate. Okay? Also in your, so a copy of the physical is in your notebook or in a folder. Concussion, sudden cardiac arrest knowledge form is also in there. You can look at that. It sounds scarier than what it is. All right? What else you need to do? Well, if you're able to, start coming to the weight room. We're all Whiting students here. We can now start coming to the weight room. Now, schools come, get out at different times and such, and that, it is what it is. But start making arrangements to come, okay? We have a protein policy in there. Coach talked about eating a lot of good protein. We offer kids protein after workouts every single day, all right, at no cost. So in there is a permission slip. I have the, just if you want to see the ingredients, I'll be happy to provide you with that. And we have the attendance policy in there, so you need to sign that. So this list is what you kind of got to do, okay? We've thrown a lot of stuff at you, but there it is right there. This is the most important stuff. All right, last thing I promise, just some expectations. So I got to give some expectations to the parents, okay? We want you to support your kid. Football is hard, okay? Waking up every day, going to practice is hard. That stuff is hard. Support your kid. You don't support them, though, by always giving them a hug. You support them by, you know what, you need to get you behind out of bed and get to practice. That's supporting your kid, okay? You know, your kid had a bad day. Support the kid. Listen to him. That kind of stuff, that emotional stuff that's important. But also, sometimes you got to be the tough parent. Support him, okay? Get your kid his player packet, all right? $65 is a lot of money. I understand, okay? I understand. But let's work hard to try to get that done, okay? Help fundraise, all right? Even if it's selling one $5 ticket, that's at least helping, okay? Don't just throw stuff to the side and say, I don't give a crap about Jevons. Well, it isn't really me, it's the kids, right? Well, I may eat a slice of pizza. All that money goes to the kids. It really does. And I'm telling you, we give your kids a ton. We try to run this thing as classy as we can. But we need money, so that's the bottom line. So please fundraise. Be involved. We have a parents club I haven't really talked about. But that's an opportunity for you to get involved and socialize with other parents, okay? So we do Thursday Moms Club dinner. We do Saturday morning Dad's breakfast. I'm telling you, there's some good food being out there on Saturday mornings. It's awesome. I mean, we have like tamales and chorizo and all kinds of stuff. And then there's pancakes, but you know where I'm going to. All right? So, yeah, be involved. Come to games and just be a part of this. It becomes a family pretty fast. It really does. All that stuff and all that, you know, attendance policy, that's all the bad stuff I got to talk about. Well, this is the fun stuff, man. Coming to games on Fridays, all right? And hanging out with people in the stands to become your friends and family, all right? A couple of things I got to say. I don't care if you don't really like us, all right? I don't care if you disagree with a lot of what we're doing. That's fine, man, all right? I'm okay with that. The couple of things I just ask of you, don't talk bad about us to your kid, okay? And that just kind of undermines everything. We're trying to really do good, okay? We really are. We really care about your kid. So if you don't like that your kid is playing this position, you feel like he should be playing that other position, we're not doing it because we're picking on the kid. We're doing what we feel like is best for all involved. So, hey, to your significant other, to other parents in the stands, rip on us all you want. But to the kid, at least try to keep that stuff to a minimum, okay? One thing I'm gonna tell you what, it really kind of upsets me, and I'm a guy that's pretty easy to get along, is don't take to social media and complain. I hate social media. We do a lot of it, but it really kind of irritates me when parents go out and say, man, Jennings sucks, he didn't punt on fourth down when it's fourth and eight. You know, well, first off, I just don't get what you're really looking to accomplish. To be honest with you, if you disagree with something, don't post, everybody just tell me. Then post it on social media, and then I gotta see it and get mad. All right? Complain all you want, just please, just keep it away from the kids. That's just the one thing that I do ask, okay? And the bottom line is, just communicate with us. In there is a business card of mine. On the back is my cell phone number, all right? I am not too good to answer a phone call or to talk to you, all right? I am just a coach. So if you're feel like your kid isn't being treated fairly, or there's an issue with him, someone, it doesn't matter, I'll really talk about it. I don't really want to talk about playing time, okay? I really don't want to talk about play calling, but honestly, anything else, I'm there for your kid, I really am, we all are. All right, so if you want to talk to Coach Gendris, text me and say, hey, what's Gendris' number? I'm going to ask why you need it, and then I'll give you the number, okay? But that's, I don't have a business phone, and that's my cell phone, all right? So when my wife yells at me, she texts me on that same phone, all right? So, yes, I'm telling you, text me if there's a problem. Let's work through problems before they become big problems, okay? I think this stuff is fair. Bad mouth us all you want up in the stands or to your significant other. Just try to keep away from the kids. That's the one thing I kind of hope, and just not on social media. Finally, what can you expect from us? Okay? I told you at the beginning, we're going to hold your kid accountable. We're a great program because of accountability. We really are. And that we do. We're going to hold your kid accountable. We're not one of those teams that are going to say, well, don't worry about those consequences. We sent a kid out in a regional in 2015. The regional. That's a huge game. Okay? That stuff's going to happen. Push your kid. All right? That's what we're going to push your kid to be a better person. Never mind football. We're going to go out there and we're going to try to make your kid better. How can you fault us for that? All right? We're going to communicate with you. Obviously, we communicated an hour and a half tonight. We can talk. All right? Social media, texting, all that stuff. My cell phone number. We're going to communicate. Work with us. We have energy. I'm big, but I got a lot of energy, and we'll get at it. All right? We're extremely prepared individuals. All right? We really are. So we're not going to go out there with a game plan like crap on Friday nights. These guys put a lot of hours in and work their tails off. And we're going to work hard for your kid, all right? Told you, we're not going to really discuss playing time, all right, or play calling. Don't come down after the game and say, why did you do that on 4th and 8? That's not going to end well. Let's just not even get into that stuff, okay? All right, and finally, we're here for your kids. Football is about relationships. We care about every single individual kid that walks through that door, all right? And I told you at the very beginning of this, football is just a medium for us to try to help your kid become a better person, a better husband, a better father. That's what we're here for, all right? Football just happens to be the vehicle that we can get that across, all right? That's it. We have a few things. Make sure that you signed in that packet. We have a little thing called Junior Oiler Booster Club. It's for kids first through fifth grade next year. If your kid don't go to Whiting and you want to sign them up, all kinds of cool stuff. Take a look at that. We're also online. I'm selling some hats. I had some guys ask about some hats. Hats are $20. T-shirt, $5 if we got your size. All right. Finally, have car wash tickets in your folder. If you have taken, like if your family took multiple folders, you don't want to sell multiple tickets. Give me back one of those envelopes. All right? Sell the tickets. You don't sell it, sell me. Give me back the money or give me back the unused tickets. All right? Thank you. I hope this was helpful. I hope you feel good. If you want to talk about it, anything, I'm here after. Text me, call me, and we'll go from there. Thank you guys for sticking around.